How's it, folks? I want to discuss the possible ways we would be able to travel between the stars in Starfield. But let me first begin by saying I am not a rocket scientist, but I will be trying to explain the method of interstellar travel in a relatively easy to understand manner. Bear in mind, this is a video game and it doesn't have to be realistic. I just think it's fun to come up with potentially realistic scenarios that would make something set in a sci-fi universe realistic and what we would need to accomplish in order to get to a similar technological level. So let us begin with what we have been shown of the interstellar travel so far.
You should feel like you're in complete control every step of the way.
And then we get Todd Howard explaining the specific method of interstellar travel they use in Starfield in a recent interview with Kinda Funny Games.
I presume that Starfield has its own version of all that tech lore, right? This is how we're able to travel faster than light. This is how we're able to communicate faster than light.
Definitely. I mean, we say grav drive here, but it stands for the graviton loop field array, the way the different bands bend space in front of you, and the more it can bend it, and you're actually taking space and you're folding it. You're bringing the space towards you. There's some great papers out there on like warp drives and quantum physics.
I was going to say, this is not dissimilar to warp drive, right? Where you contract the space in front of you and expand the space behind you.
Technically, like, that's what it is.
So there we had Todd Howard confirming the interstellar travel is based off using warp drives, where in-game they are called grav engines. Even if you aren't familiar with the various forms of potential interstellar travel, you may have heard of warp drives that were popularized by Star Trek.
I'm telling you, we rely too much on 24th century technology, Captain. You give me a window and a sextant, and I guarantee I'll get you where you want to go.
Rather than accelerating a ship to past the speed of light, which many hypothesize to be impossible, warp engines instead bend space itself. It essentially compresses space in front of the craft and expands it behind it. You can think of it as the spacecraft essentially riding a bubble of normal 3D space while the universe changes around it. This all sounds a little fantastical, especially comparing it to Star Trek, but it may actually be possible. Sort of. In 1994, a Mexican scientist called Miguel Alcubierrez proposed a means of FTL space travel consistent with general relativity, from that guy you know with the funny hair. As mentioned previously, his speculative drive would contract space in front and expand space behind, allowing the spacecraft to sort of ride a wave forward. Unfortunately, there are a couple of problems with this hypothetical drive, with the biggest issue being the truly massive amounts of energy, as well as a yet unknown material that would be needed to use the warp drive. Star Trek got around it by using a made-up element called dilithium in crystal form, and until we have something like that, the warp drive will remain a hypothetical. Perhaps the in-universe reason in Starfield that warp drives or grav engines are used will be because they have their own material to fuel the engines. What that material is, or how humanity got a hold of it, I am not sure. But it does appear to be something humanity can produce, as there was a fuel gauge shown off in the presentation that lowered depending on the distance and number of jumps made. I'm hoping that there is an explanation on how grav drive works, and if it was something humanity discovered during early space travel, or if it was something they manufactured. Personally, I'm leaning more towards the discovery route, as during the showcase, there was a brief clip of what appeared to be a colony ship that was surprised to see another human, which suggests that they left fairly early on and were traveling at a much slower speed that was eventually overtaken by the more advanced warp drive grav engine. What are some of the alternatives to the warp drive? Firstly, the obvious answer would be wormholes or Einstein-Rosen bridges, which essentially act as a shortcut between two points in space. The MCU uses a lot of them, and a recently released space game called Everspace 2 also makes great use of this FTL travel. The other possibility, although I think it's the least likely, would be jump drives, or basically teleportation. This is a convenient trope that is often used in sci-fi, but if you stretch it a bit and squint your eyes a little, you can kind of give a scientific answer. Quantum entanglement is when groups of particles behave similarly even when separated by a large amount of space. In theory, you could teleport a ship or person, using this technology, but it gets a little complicated. You would have to somehow transcribe quantum information from particles at one end and transfer them to particles on the other end. This would allow you to get out of other problems caused by fictional teleportation, namely having to unalive yourself or create a clone of yourself every time you teleport it. So basically, I don't see this happening anytime soon. Do any of you have theories on how interstellar travel works in Starfield? I would love to hear from you in the comments down below. A like and subscribe will help me to know you would like to see more of this type of content and help my channel grow. Otherwise, I hope you all have a fantastic day. Take care and cheers for now.